up, everybody? Welcome back to my YouTube channel, Life Vanessa. Y'all already know. What's up, guys? Welcome back. Okay, so today's video is something that I've been working on for like about 4 weeks, maybe 3 weeks. I wanted this jacket to look really dope and like perfect, so it took me a little more than I wanted to, but it's finally done. So you guys are about to see how I made it today. And then at the end of this video, there's like a little lookbook of my friend modeling the jacket and me modeling the jacket. So you guys will get to see that. So stay tuned for that. And I hope you guys enjoyed it. This was something that I had a lot of fun with. It was like my pure creativity. I just sketched it out. Also, I hope you guys get creative with some piece of clothing of your own. And, you know, go crazy, go stupid, go ah.
Yeah, but no, you can say it like that.
It's no good. Go crazy, go stupid, ah! Enjoy this video, guys. Guys, so I'm about to start the jacket. I'm a little nervous, one, because this is my first time doing this, and I just really wanted it to come out super dope. I have all my ugly clothes on because I don't want to damage, you know, my good clothes. Okay, so this is Travis. Obviously, you cannot have low flame without some flames. So behind Travis, I'm going to be adding some flames. And obviously, what is Travis without his famous butterflies? You know, he loves butterflies, butterfly effect. Just for like some details, I'm adding some like lightning bolts. And then obviously, Le Flame on the top. I know the letters should look butt right now. They're all uneven, but that's gonna be all fixed with paint. Guys, I'm switching on to voiceover, so enjoy it. Okay guys, so for the beginning of the jacket, I took red, orange, and a little bit of black, and I mixed it all together to create the flames that are behind Travis. This is one of my favorite parts because love flames, so you know, I had to draw some flames. So I outlined it first, and then I filled each flame up, and then at the end I added a little bit of orange because it was like too dark, so I wanted the orange to like brighten it up a little bit to make like the flames look like more realistic. So yeah, that's what you see me doing here. And then after I did his flames, they did come out a little dark still, but I don't mind. I took this thin brush and I used white to outline his t-shirt. And I was trying to be really careful on this part because I didn't want the paint to smear anywhere, especially on the flames because they took forever. And then slowly I just started painting his t-shirt, and I know you guys see that like circle thing there. I ended up like painting over that just because it was supposed to be a part of his chain, but I didn't like it. So yeah, I ended up like painting it over, as you can see. And also, I was having a little bit of trouble with this white because the blue from the denim jacket started bleeding through. So I just kept like layering white paint all over it and like trying to smooth it out and make it like look good and like stroke it perfectly, so that way you wouldn't be able to see like any more blue because it was like really bothering me, you know. Okay, so after I did his t-shirt, I started doing his chain, and I did this by adding blue, pink, and yellow, and I was just like creating like these little ovals which like signify his like crystals on his chain. So yeah, and then after I did that, I outlined them in gray to like show like, you know, the silverness of like each diamond, I guess. And then yeah, I did that all the way around, and this was like my favorite part because I love his chain. I think it's so dope. And yeah, you know, gotta make him iced out.
Guys, okay, so before you guys watch the next few clips, I just wanted to let you guys know that it is not me painting Travis Scott or the butterfly. My cousin painted those two because I wanted Travis to look like Travis, and I knew if I was gonna do it, he was not gonna look like Travis. And she knows how to like paint and stuff. So yeah, shout out to her. It looks so dope. You guys will see at the end of the video how it turned out. But yeah, and I know it kind of like ruins like the DIY of the video, but I just had to do it. I'm sorry, but everything else I did, I swear.
Okay, so for Travis's face, my cousin started off by outlining his face, of course. I'm the one who drew the sketch, and yeah, so she's kind of like just going over it with black. From there, she started filling it with like brown paint. And I like the way my cousin paints because, like I said, she has like these like methods on like how to like make like the paint just looks so abstract. And yeah, as you can tell, like she starts like just like using like dark browns and like light browns and then like mixing them different ways, and like then she started using black, and then she started using like white after she like did his like eyebrows and like his nose. I don't know why, but this looks so cool to me. It just looks like so abstract and like really shows his features. And yeah, that's something I would never be able to do. So like, shout out to her. As you can tell, like she did his eyes, his like face features, everything.
From here, she started just like touching it up a little bit. She started adding more like random colors. I don't know what this girl does, but it looks so cool. I love it. Okay guys, so this part is me now. So I took this like light blue that I made and I outlined the background of my jacket so I wouldn't get all over the other things, and then I just started filling it in. So after outlining the flames and all that stuff, I did paint the background blue, but unfortunately I did lose that footage. So now I'm just filling in my letters, my flame letters. I did outline them first and then I started to fill them in very slowly because I didn't want to smear paint once again. And girl, let me tell you, this was the hardest part because these letters were like not the same size, or they like were crooked, or they were too much paint, so it was so much. But yeah, I know they still come out a little crooked, but don't worry, I did end up fixing that. So yeah. All right guys, so the last part, it was Travis's chain, and by Travis's chain I mean filling it in with like these rhinestones that I had. So I started off by putting super glue, then I would take my tweezer and then take the rhinestone and like put it on there. This was really hard because you have to make them align and like in the right place, and like they move a lot. So I was just taking the glue and my tweezer and trying to fix it. But yeah, so I did this all the way around his chain. I thought it looked so dope. It was obviously my favorite part to do because like look at it, it's like 3D and I love it. All right my lovers, that was my DIY of my Travis jacket. I hope you guys enjoyed it, but now it's time to see the final result. Ain't nobody troubler than me, ain't nobody troubler than Scott. Ain't nobody trouble, man, I'm taking this spot. Yeah, these niggas is here. Thunders in the city moving slow. 30, 30, 30, 500 for the call. Only real niggas keep you flow, keep you flow. Only true niggas I know. 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 Ladies, hold up the champagne, a whole lot of it. Painkillers, they got